So today, me and Rumbi, my wife, are going to be going for a walk, and we're going to be discussing some of the differences, similarities between medicine and dentistry. She's a medical doctor, and I'm a dentist, so we'll be able to just talk and, see if there's a lot more in common or if there are some big differences. And it should help, especially with those that are considering a career in one or the other. It should help. Okay, so a lot of people say that it's more competitive to apply for medicine. Some might say it's more competitive to apply for dentistry. But the unique position that me and Rumbi were in was that we applied to both. I applied to medicine and dentistry. She applied to medicine and dentistry. So Rumbi, did you find it difficult trying to get into dentistry?
I think I found it difficult to try and get into dentistry because I hadn't planned it well. I hadn't gained the necessary sort of experience in.
What experience did you have?
So I had a 2 week placement
Yeah.
with a dentist. She showed me a lot of different procedures, but I think unfortunately because it wasn't hands-on, I didn't enjoy it that much. And I looked at a lot of applications and a lot of dental schools for what they look for, and it mentions a lot about manual dexterity skills. So I sort of just pieced together a knitting thing. I made a scarf, and that's what I mostly had in terms of my manual dexterity. I didn't
Yeah.
play piano, and I wasn't really into
Yeah.
sports.
So you had the 2 weeks experience, you had the
Yeah. The
knitting.
knitting, and I did my
So
own
did you get
hair.
interviews?
Yeah, so I actually got one interview in Glasgow,
Yeah.
and I prepared my best for it. I sort of practiced and took my scarf with me,
Yeah.
and I went for it. And I thought I gave it a good go, but unfortunately, I didn't get
You
it.
didn't get. So what were your grades like? Because maybe it was your grades that let you down.
So, my grades were actually really good, because I did biology, maths, chemistry, and further maths, and I was predicted A's in biology, chemistry, and maths. And further maths, I did it at AS level, and I got an A. So, yeah, my grades are pretty good.
So the grades were there, but
Yeah.
you still didn't get in.
No.
And then you ended up applying for medicine.
Yes.
Yeah. So how did that go?
So I think I finished my A levels and I actually got the A's, and then I think I took a year out and I worked as a healthcare assistant. And during that time, I really reflected on what I really want to do as a career, because I
Yeah.
think dentistry was based on the advice of some brilliant friends and family members who felt that it would be good for family life
Yeah.
later on. But I think my passion was more kind of sided towards medicine. Yeah, I loved the interaction with patients. I remember I used to watch the GP come to the nursing home and just chat to the patients, and I just loved it. And I remember.
Did you get more interviews with medicine?
That's the funny thing. No. I also had one interview for medicine, and it was at University of Leicester. I remember I prepared my hardest for it, but this interview felt more natural. That's what I would say. It felt more natural, and I think having taken the year out, I was more emotionally ready for interviews, because interviews are very, they're more about your body language, how you relate to the interviewers, and less about what you actually say, and it's more your confidence and those interpersonal skills rather than head knowledge.
So you ended up getting into medicine. So, I mean, what would you say to, like, when people say that it's harder to get into dentistry or it's harder to get into medicine?
Well, I think they're both equally as hard. Yeah. As you can tell from my story, I got one interview for dentistry and I also got one interview for medicine.
Yeah.
So they were equally challenging. But I think it's all in the preparation. My dentistry interview, I wasn't prepared. I didn't have sort of, I didn't have anything to offer really, but my scarf and my grades.
Yeah.
But for my medicine interview, I'd done a year of work experience. I'd seen doctors at work and I'd done so much. So I was a lot more prepared for that.
I applied to medicine. So when I was in sixth form, I made an application to medicine. I remember I applied to Bristol, Imperial, I applied to Cambridge, and I applied to Nottingham Medical School. And the only interview that I got was the Cambridge interview. I had four A2 subjects. So I had maths, biology, chemistry, as well as further maths. And I came out with three A's and a B, so my grades were okay. But still, even after the Cambridge interview, I didn't get in. So that was actually quite devastating. Ended up spending that application process going through clearing. I was trying to find any way I could get into medicine. So that was thinking about, you know, maybe even applying to Europe. But what I found was this course in Leicester, which allowed you to do 1 year on the course and then transfer to the Leicester Medical School. Remember Leicester, that's where we met. So I was on that course in Leicester. But what I found out in that year was that I didn't have a passion to continue applying for medicine. So I looked at what else I could do as a career. And that's where dentistry really came into my mind, and I really started to consider dentistry as a potential career. So I ended up finding out what I needed to do, work experience. I did weeks of work experience, shadowing, and I ended up getting two interviews for dentistry. That was with Liverpool and that was with UCLan in Preston. And what I found was that because I was now older, more mature, that my approach at interview was much better. And that really did help me in securing the two offers for UCLan and Liverpool. But I don't think that one is harder than the other necessarily to apply for. I think it's about finding out what you're passionate about, and what you're passionate about is going to help you to be more competitive at interview. So I think for me, when I found out all that was involved with dentistry, I was really excited and I was passionate to really learn the ins and outs of dentistry, dental school, the career, and that helped me to shine in interviews. So I don't think one's more competitive than the other. I just think it's matching yourself up to the right course.
Yeah.
So one thing people might be considering is, okay, once you get into medical school or dental school, which one's going to take more time out of your week? Is one busier than the other? How did you find it? I mean, Monday to Friday, did you have free days? Did you have options to do hobbies? And
well, with Leicester, the first 2.5 years is lecture based and more academic, yeah, really. And then for the other 2.5 years, it's more placement. So for the academic years, if I remember correctly, I was in there Monday to Friday. We had lectures. On Wednesday, we finished in the afternoon, and you could do some sports Wednesday afternoons and get involved in, like, you know, any groups. Because I remember I did CMF, which is Christian Medical Fellowship, on Wednesdays. So you do have some time, but it's not a lot.
So you didn't have like a whole free day or
no
things like that?
3 days. Who gives 3 days to medics?
You know what? It was quite similar for myself. I remember it was, we're told you had to have, I think it was 95% attendance rate throughout the course. So you couldn't just be skipping on lectures or lessons. You had to have good reasons for not being able to make a lecture or a lesson. Maybe you were ill. And even then, you probably needed a doctor's note or something just to show and prove that. So not much time during the week to do anything else. But you can have things like part-time jobs over the weekends if you're very organized, if you're able to plan your time effectively between studying and having a job, part-time job. So not much difference. I don't think there's much difference.
No, it's really Monday to Friday, yeah. Really, except Wednesday afternoons, I suppose.
Yeah. So after graduation, in dentistry, you get 1 year foundation year. In medicine, you get...
2 years. So 2 foundation years, and then you decide what specialised area you want to focus on. Right. Or you can still be quite general as well.
Did you find that when you started working after graduation, it was what you thought it would be? Or was it different?
So I thought it was going to be, you know, a steep learning curve, and I knew it was going to be quite intense. And it was, and I learned a lot. However, I think I hadn't sort of realized how much responsibility it would be. And I know that sounds strange, but because as a medical student, like, you can practice doing a cannula. If you don't get it, it's fine. But when you're actually working the job, you need to make a plan. So if you can't get the cannula, then you need to either decide they need, you know, oral medication, or are you going to escalate it to someone else to try it? So I think it's, you know, just the responsibility of things was a lot more than I thought.
Well, no. I think for dentistry, you definitely do get more of a independence during your foundation year. But for me, because I went to UCLan Dental School, from the end of year one, they allow you to start treating NHS patients who are paying. So for 4 years, we got the opportunity to have that independence in how we worked and practiced. So my 1 year foundation year, I enjoyed it. It was good. You had your own surgery, your own room. They had the little plaque outside saying Dr. Arnold. So it was nice. I think it was better than what I expected. The fact that you really started to have your own patient list, patients that returned to see you, and building that rapport, building that relationships with patients. So I think it was better than what I thought it would be.
And to be honest, I think, I know I mentioned how you get a lot more responsibility after you graduate, but it is quite fulfilling. And I remember coming home, you know, on days when things would have gone well, buzzing. So, you know, there is, you know, the highs and lows of practicing, but you get more independent the more experienced you are in medicine. So my first foundation year was quite intense because I wasn't experienced, but my second foundation year I found was more, you know, interesting, more fulfilling, because you get more responsibilities, you know how to do more procedures. So yeah, it gets better as you go along.
Everyone has to go through foundation years, really. In dentistry, you have to do the foundation year if you want to be able to treat NHS patients. So the majority of dentists do a foundation year. Is it the same for medicine?
So in medicine, it's mandatory. You have to do 2 foundation years. Mm. You can't progress to do anything else really without doing your foundation years to work in the UK.
Okay, so everyone's had to do that. After that, you know, what was it like for you in terms of choosing where you were going to go next?
So I did my foundation years, and I think when you start, you sort of have an idea of what you want to specialize in or where you want to end up. I think when I started, I was quite open. I loved the general specialties, so I loved pediatrics, I loved elderly medicine, and so I was quite open. But I think the further I got into foundation training, and you know, I did on calls in medicine, all the doctors know about that. Those are some of the most grueling jobs you'd ever do, weekend on calls. And I thought to myself that I don't think I want to go down that path. But I still wanted to be a generalist, so I was drawn towards general practice. When I did my placement in general practice, not my placement, my job in general practice in my second foundation year, I really enjoyed it. And I think as well, my mentor was a massive help towards that, because he was really passionate and he was really encouraging. And when I told him that I was interested in general practice, he just invested so much in me. So yeah, I ended up applying for general practice.
Did you go straight into general practice from the foundation years?
Actually, I didn't. So I took a year out again after my second foundation year. And in that year out, I actually did some teaching in university as a medical demonstrator. Okay. In University of Central Lancashire, so where you did your dentistry. Yeah. That was quite interesting. And I think it opened my mind as well to, you know, to all the other different career options you can have with a medical degree. You don't have to be a doctor. You can be an educator, you can work in a company, you know, you can do loads of different things.
Okay, so how did you find that teaching for a year? Because you just done 2 years of foundation and you went straight into teaching. Was that different to what you thought it would be?
I really enjoyed it, I really did. Because in foundation year, the shift patterns meant that I missed a lot of birthdays, a lot of family occasions, and I worked some weekends and bank holidays. So it was really nice to just have those times off, to just you know, have the freedom to do what you want to do with your weekends. And also it was really fulfilling, you know, working with first year medical students, you know, physician associates, and just, you know, helping someone else sort of make that step in medical school. That was really fulfilling.
Actually, and you got to do some interviews as well for students. Yes. How was that? Actually being on the other side and now interviewing students.
So it was really interesting, because I think I realised more now that interviews are not really about, you know, who you are on paper. They're not really about what you know, but it's about how you put yourself across and, you know, those interpersonal skills. So it felt like I was watching myself in that dentistry interview and in that medical interview, and seeing the difference and the two different people who I was. So it was really interesting, really interesting.
And I would say, I mean, for myself, after my foundation year, you get the option to go into hospital. You can apply for that, or you can remain within general practice. And I just had to stay within general practice. So for me, in terms of progressing, it meant actually investing in courses. So looking at what courses are out there and what sort of dentistry I want to do. So for me, I was now passionate about braces, and I ended up going on some different courses to learn about braces and to be able to start using them to treat patients and to straighten teeth. So I find that in dentistry, the onus is now on you to really invest in yourself and to pay for courses as you go towards the type of dentist that you want to be. How would you say?
I think they're quite similar in that even in medicine, you do have the opportunity, you know, to go on different courses, but it depends which route you pick. So I know friends who decided to, you know, go down the surgical route, they had to do courses early on because, you know, for your CV you needed different things. But having chosen general practice, I didn't need to do as many courses prior to applying, and most of the courses were provided by my foundation school, so I didn't have to, you know, do any courses outside of that.
That's it for today. I hope you found that useful. Just some similarities and some differences between medicine and dentistry. So again, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on more videos, and hope you have a good day.